doesn't work there. It just happens. And it happens when it happens. You cannot force it also. So there's no fixed thing that, you know, in this rag you can only have the speeds. But yes, there are some rags which sound better in slow speed and some rags which sound better in fast speed. But if a composer is skillful enough, he could even break these things and compose something which where the rag is still maintained even in like some other speed. So yeah. So shall we move on? So now I'm going to introduce you to a rag called Gaud Malhar. So it has these re pa ma pa dha sa da pa ma pa ma. This will be there. But you have the Malhar framework and a lot of other things grafted onto it. So you have just five swaras in Shuddha Malhar. Sa re ma pa dha. Now what do? You're adding ga and ni to that. Ga and both the knees, komal as well as tibra, sharp. So now Gaud Malhar is a combination of three ragas. In the Purvang, in the lower notes, you have Gaud. In the Uttarang, you have a little bit of Bilawal. And in Purvang and Uttarang both, you have Malhar. So, ma pa dha sa da pa ma pa ma. This is Shuddha Malhar. Or it can also be Gaud Malhar, but ma pa dha ni sa da ni pa ga pa ma. This is Gaud Malhar. Ma pa dha ni sa, instead of ma pa dha sa. But here I am putting a ni. So then ma pa dha sa will become ma pa dha ni sa. Ma pa dha ni sa da ni pa. A little bit of the other ni also. Ma pa dha ni sa da ni pa ga pa ma. Gar ma ga sa re sa. Sa de ga ma ga ma ga re ma ga sa de ga re ga ma re ba so sa de ga ma ga re ma ga sa re sa. This is Raag Gaud. So Gaud is such a Raag whose, I mean, like only the Purvang is left. Nobody sings it anymore, so we don't know how the Uttarang is supposed to be. But we just have the Purvang of Gaud in various rags, combined with other rags. Gare ma gare sa re sa. This is Gaud. Sa re gare ga ma. Still Gaud. Ma re ba. Now we came into Malhar.
Ma pa dha ni sa da ni pa.
This is Gaud Malhar's own feature. Not of Gaud or not of Malhar, it comes only in Gaud Malhar.
Ma pa dha ni sa da ni pa. Ma pa 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 da da ni pa.
This is again Gaud Malhar's own feature. So when you mix two rags, it's not just a mixture of those two rags. The new rag which you get develops its own personality, distinct personality.
So ma pa dha sa da pa ma. Gare ma gare sa re sa.
So when you do the alap of the rag, there are always two parts. There's a sthayi and an antara. Antara is when you go into the higher side of things.
Pa ni da ni sa sa re sa.
So this bit comes from Bilawal. So Gaud, Malhar, Bilawal plus own phrases. So these four things make up Gaud Malhar.
Pa ni da ni sa sa re sa 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 re ga ma ga re ga sa re sa sa da ni pa ga pa ma ga re ma ga sa re sa pa sa sa re sa.
So this is just a summary of Gaud Malhar. Now I'll sing some compositions. So you heard the Shuddha Malhar composition. When you hear this Gaud Malhar composition, you will easily see how Shuddha Malhar becomes Gaud Malhar.
Garjat barsat bheejat aailo. Garjat barsat bheejat aailo. Tumare milan ko apne de. Here
antara of the composition. So you see the first line of this antara sounds similar to the first line of the antara in the Shuddha Malhar composition which I sang. And that one is like that is in the Shuddha Malhar composition. Here you have a similar structure. There was a movie called Malhar in 1951. The movie itself was called Malhar. So there was a time when ragas were very, very commonly used in film music. So the composer of the music composer was Roshan, who actually, he's the grandfather of Hrithik Roshan. So he was actually a student of Pandit S.N. Ratanjankar, who I forgot to mention, the Shuddha Malhar composition was a composition of Pandit S.N. Ratanjankar, who was a very important musician and musicologist in the 20th century. So Roshan was his disciple and he composed this song. And later in 1960, you had another song with the same tune. Garjat barsat saawan aayo de, Garjat barsat saawan aayo de, laayo na sang me hamare bichhode balam sakhi ka karuna. It was very common to take tunes and make new lyrics for them. So this song, even though it has the same tune, it expresses a different feeling. In the first song, Garjat barsat bheejat aailo, that's a feeling of togetherness, like you're, running in the rain and getting drenched on the way to meet your lover. But the second song is like, the rain has come but the lover has not come. So the lyrics convey a different meaning. So this song, the second one, was sung by Suman Kalyanpur, quite a famous singer. I'm sure everybody knows about her. So yeah. So now coming to more like hardcore Gaud Malhar, like moving away from the film world. So I will sing a vilambit composition for a short while. But before that, are there any questions? Yeah. It depends. It depends. So some compositions. So some compositions are gharana specific.
Of
that Agra gharana. Yeah. Okay. But for example, Kaahe Ho in Gaud Malhar, everybody sings it in different ways.
Okay.
So it's a Sadarang composition. Okay. So then it's not specific. Sadarang was a very old composer, so it's not specific to any particular gharana. Then Balma, Bahaar, again everybody sings. So it depends. Some compositions are not gharana specific. Some anybody will sing. Like for example, the Nat Malhar composition which I sang, Pandit Ramashray Jha has sung it, and he says it is paramparik. And in his gharana, that is the gharana of Pandit Bholanath Bhatt, apparently Nat Malhar was very common. So now before I move on to the composition, there are some subtle points of difference between Gaud Malhar and Nat Malhar, which I did not include in my PPT, but I just want to tell you. This is Gaud Malhar.
Ga pa ma.
This is Gaud Malhar.
Re pa ma pa ni ni.
But again, nut Malhar is not uniquely defined. It depends on the musician, like, you know, which aspect of nut and which aspect of Malhar, and also which aspect of which nut and which aspect of which Malhar that you want to combine. Because nut is another family of rags. Now, at least in the one which I sing, according to what Pandit Ramashri Jha has sung, it's like this. So, this is Gaud Malhar. This is nut Malhar.
Ma pa sa da ni pa re ga ma pa ma ga ma sa re sa.
And again, even when I sing sa re ga ma, there's also a difference between Gaud Malhar and Nut Malhar.
Sa re ga ma ga ma sa re ga ma.
This is Gaud.
Sa re 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 ga.
These two things are nut features. So in Gaud Malhar you have the former, in Nut Malhar you have the latter. So coming to the composition in Gaud Malhar, it's in Tilwada taal, a slow taal of 16 beats. We don't know. It's not easy to trace these things. I don't know. I'll have to find out about it. Just with akar, without using the words. Thank you.
rang tumma parwa Balma bahaar aaye, Balma bahaar aaye, Dadur mor papihaar.
So Dadur mor papihaar, which I told you in the beginning. Frog, peacock and the hawk. Did not refer to the spring, but it means like Barkha Bahar. Like this old song, O Sajna Barkha Bahar Aayi. So in that sense, Bahar is being used to mean the monsoon here in this composition. So now, coming to a very interesting raag called Miyan Malhar, which will be very different from the other Malhars that you've been hearing so far. But before that, before we move on to Miyan Malhar, let's just take one or two questions. Yeah. Yeah, you would take it differently. Like, ga re sa sa re. This and all is not. Sa re re ga ga ma. Sa re re ga ga ma. Ma pa ma ga re sa re. Ma pa ni ni sa da ni pa ma ma ga re ga ma pa ma ga re ga. Re ga ma pa ma ga ma re sa. This would be not Malhar. But God Malhar, it will be like re ga re. Ma re pa ma pa da ni sa da ni. Pa ga pa ma ga re ma ga sa re sa ga pa ma ga re ma ga sa re ga re ma ga re sa sa ma re pa ni da 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 ni pa da ga pa ma re ga re ma ga re sa. This is all nut. Sa re ga ma ga ma sa re ga ma sa sa re ga ma ga ma ma re pa ma pa da ni sa da da ni pa ga pa ma ga ma ga re sa re ga ma ga ma. But sa re re ga ga ma, this is all is nut. So you would keep that difference. And also the dha, ma pa pa da da ni pa, this is less in nut Malhar. Ma pa ni ni sa da pa pa da pa ma pa ga ma re. So yeah, you should maintain the difference between the rags even in the taal. Yeah. Was there any other question? Yes, please. Not as far as I know. It's different. It's different. Okay, I'm not actually. No. So, I mean, Western music, the principles are different. So, I can't really, I mean, comment on that because I'm not trained in Western music. So, I think for that, you'll have to ask somebody who's an expert in both, I think. So, anyway, now moving on to Miyan Malhar. Miyan Malhar does not have as much Malhar as, say, God Malhar or Nut Malhar would. It has some more of Kannada, which is another rag, and it has a lot of its own phrases as well. So, only this Malhar bit will come in Miyan Malhar. But then you also have Kannada, I mean, which is not, I mean, it's not exactly the same as the way it would. So, Kannada is another big family of rags. You have many types of Kannada. So, Miyan Malhar is kind of close to that, but it's not exactly the same. Like, ni pa ma pa ga ma re sa. This komal ga. I'm not just singing ni pa ma pa ga ma re sa. No. Ni pa ma pa ga ma re sa. This is the Kannada. It's a bit of Kannada. But in Miyan Malhar, the oscillation of the ga is much more exaggerated. Ni pa ma pa ga. This is the Miyan Malhar ga, which is a more exaggerated or more slow oscillation version of the Kannada Gandhara. And he also has some own phrases like ma pa ni da ni ni sa. So you're having both the knees here. Ni, this knee, and ni, this knee. But the komal knee, the flat knee, comes like, it's not ma pa ni da ni sa. This is not correct. Ma pa ni da ni sa sa da ni ma pa ma pa ma pa ni ni pa ma pa ma pa ni pa pa ga ma re sa sa ni. You play with both the knees like this. So I'm just alternating between the two knees with little bit dha. This is the way it is, but so when I start the alap, I will start. So the other rags which I sang for you till now, they are uttarang prasa. They go in the higher octaves. But this one, Miyan Malhar, is Purvang Pratham. It starts from below and slowly moves up. So it's one of these big rags which you can even sing for an hour. But I will not be doing that because I have to also talk about Raag Megh. So,
Da da da.
karna.
That you saw, God Malhar, Nut Malhar, in them the ma, this note is very important. But in Mia Malhar, it's a little less because you only have this marepa part from Malhar. The rest is from other things. Kannada plus the own phrases, like this particular peculiar komal ni, which is there only in Mia Malhar. So, sound words which you'll come find in these compositions. Like papiha piu piu karat. The piu piu is the sound of the papiha, the bird. Rimjhim is the sound of the rain.
Rimjhim. Yeah.
So now all of you must have heard the film song Bole Re Papi Hara. So it's like
Bole Re Papi Hara, Papi Hara, Bole Re Papi Hara, Papi Hara.
But this is not the actual, I mean, so film songs are based on raag, they're not in the raag. So the actual original Bole Re Papi Hara would sound something like this.
Bole Re Papi Hara, Bole Re Papi Hara, Bole Re Papi Hara, Ab Ghan Gara Jeva, Ab Ghan Gara Jeva, Ab Ghan Gara Jeva, Bole Re Papi Hara.
Or I can even make it faster. Ma pa da ni sa, this is also permissible. Malhar. And like before I started Meg, let us take a few more questions.
Media has got nothing to do with
Tansen. So the thing is, I mean, we don't know. Okay. Because Tansen was the 16th century and the raags at that time were very, very different. Like the Kannada ang which you have now, it was not there in the 16th century. So this was not there. It didn't have the Karnata mela. The Kannada comes from Karnata. So the Karnata raga of older times did not have a komalga. It had a tivraga. So sare gama padhani sa nidhapa magade sa. It's the old Karnata mela. So after that, things have undergone changes. And Tansen was in the 16th century. So we don't know whether this was the raga that Tansen created or not. This is modern Miyan Malhar. This is what we are singing today. Raags always evolve. That cannot be stopped. So this is the Miyan Malhar that we sing today. I mean, I can tell this with certainty. And same for Miyan Ki Todi, you know. The Miyan Ki Todi which we sing now was not there in Tansen's time at all. Like the earlier Todi had all Komal swans. Like, sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga de sa. This was the old Todi scale. But now when we sing Miyan Ki Todi, it is Ga ni sa re ga ga pa ma pa da ma ga re ga re sa ni sa da ma da ni sa re ga re sa. This is Miyan Ki Todi which we sing now, but it was not there in the Tansen's time. Like Peter Manuel, he has written an article about the evolution of Todi rags in Hindustani music. And this Miyan Ki Todi which we sing now, he says that it came only in the 20th century or maybe a little before it. Otherwise, the earlier Todi had all Swaras Komal, which is the same scale which Carnatic Todi has today. And Carnatic Todi again is something which entered Carnatic music in the 18th century from the north. So that's another long discussion. Yeah. Yes, please. There are many different musicologists who chronicle these things, and I mean all these old musical texts are available online nowadays. So I don't know if there's any one institution, but there are many people who have access to these texts. And yeah, nowadays all the 16th and 17th and 18th century texts are available online. So there are musicologists who have made websites and put these things there. So I've been through those texts. Yeah. Yeah?
How does one cry for another?
Sorry?
How does one cry for another?
There are many different things. Like, for example, in Jaipur Gharana, the vilambit composition will mostly be in Teentaal, 16 beats. And they have a particular way of singing. Like, suppose I say Nat Malhar. They would sing phrases like this, and mostly in Akar. And it would be like kind of on beat. Whereas in Gwalior Gharana, suppose I'm singing Miyan Malhar. It would be more of these undulating phrases. Or in Agra Gharana, like this, something like that. Just give you examples. I mean, I'm not doing it really well because the thing is, my singing is not really restricted to one gharana. So this is just my attempt at telling you the difference between different gharanas.
So you sing one lava in
huh?
One lava in
gharana. Yeah, see, the same raag will be sung differently in different gharanas. That's the point I'm trying to make. But some raags are gharana specific. Like for example, if you have raag Basanti Kedar, raag Shuddhanat, or you know, Raag, Sampurna Malkas. These are all specific to the Jaipur Gharana. Or Agra Gharana has some again specific Raags. But then there are some Raags which are standard and which everybody sings. Like Miyan Malhar, everybody sings. Gaud Malhar, everybody sings. But again, people who sing Dhrupad will not sing the Gaud Malhar that I sang. They sing a different Gaud Malhar.
How do you sing the same Gharana?
I don't know. I mean, again, it depends. Eventually, each musician has a different style. See, now Ashwini Bhide Deshpande is also, Vidushi Ashwini Bhide Deshpande is Jaipur Gharana. Kishori Tai, Vidushi Kishori Amonka, Gaan Saraswati Kishori Amonka, she's also Jaipur Gharana. But their ways of singing are so different. Or Veena Shastrabuddhe ji, Gwalior Gharana. Ulhas Kashalkar ji, Gwalior Gharana. But they sing differently. So each musician ultimately has an individual style. So there are, I mean, like nowadays, I think the gharana is not that important. In the sense, I mean, if you've learnt in one gharana, you will obviously sing in that style. But, I mean, ultimately the important thing is what you sing should be good. It's not, doesn't matter which gharana it belongs to. I mean, you have to kind of adhere to the rules of the raag, basically. Yes? Yes. Okay, so, before we run out of time, let us move on with Raag Bheej. So it's a very special raag. I mean, that's why I've given a lot of time to make, because it's my favorite raag. So I'll sing in Dhrupal Ang. Oh, but before make, I just want to tell you about a few raags in Miyan Malhar Ang, some Miyan Malhar influenced raags. So there is Ramdasi Malhar, which has Gaud, it has Miyan Malhar, and it has a bit of Shahana. Sa-re-ga-ma. This is Gaud. Re-pa-ga-ma-de. So this is Miyan Malhar. Sa-ni-da-ni-pa. This is from Shahana. Di-ra-na-da-na. Di-ra-na-di-da-na. So there's a little surprise which I hadn't planned earlier. So I have composed something new. It's a composition in Ramdasi Malhar, which, you know, describes my anguish at the fact that it wasn't raining all these days. But did it rain today? I don't know.
Yeah.
It did. So I'll only sing the composition. Nita hi chhavat ghata samadhi. Nita hi chhavat ghata samadhi. Barsat ek bund bhunahi. Barsat ek bund bhunahi. Barsat ek bund bhunahi. Aas karat hare nar nari. Aas karat hare nar nari. Nitahi chavat kata sabari. Jeth gayo asad hai ayo. Jeth gayo asad hai ayo. So the month of Jeshtha, June, has passed and Ashada has begun.
Asad hai ayo, jeth gayo, asad hai ayo, saan dur nahi ri badariya, saan nahi ri badariya, saan dur nahi ri badariya.
Forgetting my own tune. Please just give me a minute. Kaahe.
Kaahe aise pariyaas karat ho
Okay, so there's also Jayant Malhar, which is Jai Jayanti plus Mia Malhar. Sa re ga ma ga re re ga re sa ni sa ni ga re. This is Jai Jayanti. Re ga ma pa da ga ma ga re re ga re sa. Jai Jayanti plus Mia Malhar. It's a Jod Raag. So all of Jai Jayanti and all of Mia Malhar will be seen in this Raag. So difference from say Gaud Malhar, where a little bit of Gaud, little bit of Malhar is there. This is all of Jai Jayanti sort of, you know, attached with all of Mia Malhar. So you'll alternate between Jai Jayanti and Mia Malhar phrases. And there is also Mia Ka Sarang. So Ni Sa Re Ma Pa Re Re Ma Re Ni Sa Re Sa. This is Brindavani Sarang. Ni sa re ma pa ni pa ma re ma ni pa sa ni pa ma re re pa re sa.